Yeah, Dak has scorched cover three so far this season, completing 77.3% of his passes. That's third best in the NFL. 9.5 yards per attempt, 101.4 passing yards per game. That is third. But an ounce of salt applied to those rates with the absence of both Lamb and Cooper, notes this is our guy Warren Sharp with the Nerd Football Numbers. So yeah, I think the take here is that the Chiefs, you know, thrived against the Raiders because they showed up ready to play Patrick Mahomes in the worst way possible. Could they be foolish enough to do it again, knowing how awesome Dak is at attacking that defensive scheme, guys?
I wonder, because what you're saying is, will they play Dak in a way that he's done
so well and just got him killed against the Chiefs 2 weeks ago? They got to be looking at it like, guys, we really got to go do something else.
I'm going to let the Cowboys run,
I guess.
I'm going to say no, and I'm going to tell you why. It's going to be a short week. Short week. There's
short week. You just do what you do.
You're kind of limited to what your game plan can really, really be. You know, and again, it's not a common opponent. So what do? You're going to try and put in like, hey, we're going to play press man, and we're going to play two deep, and we're going to, you know. Heck, Gus Bradley and Rod Marinelli and those guys, they had a full week to get ready for Kansas City and didn't play cover two.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so how do you expect them to like all of a sudden say, okay, we're going to play press man in here? They could try, but if you know you don't have any practices, they're going to have to travel across the country tomorrow.
Mm-hmm.
No, I mean they're going to do what they're going to do.
So they're going to go with the Vic Fangio.
I don't think they're going to go Vic Fangio. I don't. I don't see them. I kind of feel like, though, to me, it's going to be more about the single high. It's going to be what they do. You know, it's not going to be like, okay, let's try and morph into something that, you know, let's play press man here and see if we can get away with it. Hmm. There are players watching them on tape this week. I didn't see a lot of that. I didn't see a lot of get up in your face and kind of, you know, and handle their business that way.
Okay.
And the teams that have had success against Dallas two of the last 3 weeks have been able to do that. And I don't know if the Raiders can do it in a short week.
Okay.
That's all right. I'm saying there.
Other numbers from this matchup. The Cowboys have allowed just one quarterback, Teddy Bridgewater, to finish higher than quarterback 17 against them over their past six games, with Patrick Mahomes, Kirk Cousins, Matt Ryan, and Mac Jones as part of the sample. Carr has been hurt by the loss of the vertical component of this offense and is a boom or bust quarterback too. Yeah, when Henry Ruggs went out, it has devastated Derek Carr's ability to move the football. The average depth of target has been 6.9 yards downfield since the week 8 bye, 25th after 9.2 yards prior. He was 6th in the NFL. So he went from 6th in yards per target all the way to 25th, and that might be why we thought of this Raiders team as an evolving power in the AFC, and over the last 3 weeks, that's dissolved. Might be the Henry Ruggs factor and, you know, what his speed did to the defense. The Raiders are 27th in EPA per dropback over this stretch after ranking 9th at .187. The Raiders have scored on 29% of their possessions the past 3 weeks after scoring on 45% of their possessions prior.
That sounds pretty darn good for the Cowboys, doesn't it?
Oh, it's amazing. Maybe
catching somebody that ain't feeling so hot.
I will say this. I think, and you know, the whole change with John Gruden being gone now, John was the primary play caller. I think Derek Carr misses that. I really, really do. I think Greg Olsen, who's the OC calling the plays right now, I just don't think he has a real feel for what Carr looks to me like. When you watch him play it again, we'll get into Krusty's corner a little bit. But to me, it looks like there's more of this try and find the tight end. Oh, wait, I'm going to throw the ball to the backs. You know, kind of, you know, he doesn't look the same quarterback as they did in some of those early games that they had when they start off the season 5-2.
I know you have your film review coming up in 15 minutes. Very much looking forward to what that tells you. As far as a couple of more nerd numbers, one way it could go wrong is if a team runs over you. But just 22% of Raiders' offensive yardage has come from rushing, the second lowest rate in the league. They can't do it. They don't want to do it. And they have led for just 11.3% of their second half offensive snaps, 28th in the league. So it does set up well for the Cowboys to have their second straight bounce back performance after a blowout defeat.